दिस इज अवर टॉपिक ऑफ टुडे 3.3 दैट इज स्पीकिंग स्किल इन इंग्लिश. स्पीकिंग स्किल इंक्लूड्स मेनी एस्पेक्ट्स बट वी विल फोकस ऑन 3 points दैट इज प्रोनाउंसिएशन स्किल्स स्ट्रेस एंड इंटोनेशन. फर्स्ट इज स्पीकिंग इज अ स्किल. यू रिमेंबर दिस. स्पीकिंग इज अ स्किल. It is not a knowledge subject. You cannot know what is speaking. You need to do it. It is like swimming. It is like dancing. It is like singing. It is like playing piano. It is like eating. You have to do that. And in your life, how do you learn skills? By imitating somebody and then practicing that again and again. For example, you have listened many words in your life. When you were born, you have listened to some words repeatedly from your mother, from your father, from your brother, sister, and friends. Then what did you do? You started copying these words. You started imitating these words. That's how you learn to speak. So speaking is a skill. It is not a knowledge subject like science, maths, or social science. You just know it. No, skill cannot be only know. It has to be practiced. Okay? It's a process. You cannot suddenly learn a skill. You cannot suddenly learn how to ride a bicycle. It's a process. So speaking, listening, writing, and reading, all these are skills. Language itself is a skill. So it's a process. Then speaking is the second of the 4 language skills. Now focus that there are 4 skills. We know that listening, speaking, reading, and writing. So speaking is the second skill. We have discussed about the first skill, that is listening. Now it's the turn of speaking. You just think about this. Listening and speaking are related to oral communication. It is related to speaking and listening. But reading and writing are related to written communication. You write something. And when you are reading, somebody has written that. So mind well, listening and speaking are related to oral communication, and reading and writing are related to written communication. So there are 2 aspects of a language, oral aspect and written aspect. Now there are new words here, receptive skill and productive skill. Now what is receptive skill? You see here the 2 arrows. Receptive skills, there are 2 arrows. Receptive skills, listening. Receptive skills, reading. Receptive means you are just receiving the information, the ideas, the feelings. You are just listening. You are very passive. You are reading. You are almost passive. You are receiving. So they are called receptive skills. But when you are producing something, you are creating something, they are called productive skills. See here, productive skills, speaking. When you speak, you make sounds. You create sentences. You create words. You create paragraphs. You just speak it. Productive skills means you are producing something. It's like a product. When you are writing, you are also producing something. You are writing a poem, a novel, a drama. So you are producing something. So speaking and writing are productive skills. So you remember that speaking is a productive skills. You need to produce something. You are active. Then speaking is an act of making vocal sounds. Now you listen to this. What is vocal sound? You know, in our system of making speech, the vocal cords play important role. This is the system. You can see here, vocal cords. These are vocal cords. And when you make sound, if you put your hand on your throat, you will feel vibration. So when you make sounds using vocal cords, the vibration, they are called vocal sounds. It is not only making sounds. I am making sounds, right? When I cry, when I shout, when I scream, and when I sing, I make sounds. You can feel that. But when I do not make sounds, there will be no vibration here. When I'm just inhaling or exhaling the air, there will be no sound. Just letting the air go, there will be no sound. No sound. So when you make sounds, your vocal cords vibrate. You see here, these are your vocal cords. The person who has problems in these vocal cords, they cannot make sounds. So they are dumb. They cannot make sounds. They cannot speak. They are dumb. So we can say that speaking is an act of making vocal sounds. We can say that speaking means to converse, to talk with each other. Expressing one's thoughts and feelings in spoken language, that we very well know what is that. And speaking skills are the skills that give us the ability to communicate effectively. Speaking skills are the skills that give us ability to communicate. So what is communication? Communication is nothing but you share information, you exchange information, your feelings or your ideas. That is communication. So speaking skills gives the ability to communicate effectively. These skills allow the speaker to convey his message in a passionate manner, means strongly, thoughtful, means seriously, and convincing, means you explain somebody, you persuade somebody, you make somebody to believe in you. These speaking skills allow this. Then what is speaking skill? It is also an ability to convey one's message, one's the information verbally in a proper and suitable manner. It is an ability to express oneself clearly in front of others. It is an ability to express one's ideas, feelings, and thoughts. Same thing. It is an ability to give one's opinion in different matters. So when we speak, we give opinions. When we are in a group and when we are saying something, we might be giving some opinions. So that is speaking skill. Speaking is the process of producing meaningful symbols of sounds. Now sounds are also symbols, and the listener knows that what the symbol of that sound means. For example, when I say the word example, the person who knows English will understand the meaning of example. But a person who doesn't know English will not understand the meaning of sounds example. Simple. So speaking skill is just making sound symbols in the form of sounds. Sounds are also symbols. The person who can interpret, who can understand these sounds, can be said he knows the language. There are four elements of speaking skill, four components of speaking skill. First is fluency. Now, what is fluency? When you can speak fluently means without interruptions, without any nervousness, without you have to recall any words, without stopping anywhere, that is fluent speech. What is vocabulary is also important part of speaking skill, your words. How can you speak without words? So, second important part of speaking skill is words, vocabulary. The more amount of words you have, the more fluently you can speak. You can see the writers, the poets can speak fluently. You must have listened to Jaiva Savada. They have read so much, they have plenty of words in their mind, they can easily speak fluently, they can speak. Third is grammar. You know the words, but you cannot frame correct sentence. You cannot make a sentence properly because you don't know grammar. Grammar is nothing but the correct structure of any language. You cannot use any word anywhere you like. So you must first be very much fluent, then you must know many words, then you must know the grammar. This is all part of speaking skill. Then fourth and the most important is pronunciation. Each language has its own pronunciation system. Means Tamil has its own pronunciation system. Means speaking the way the language is spoken, that is pronunciation. Gujarati has its own way of speaking. Marathi has its own particular way of speaking, special way of speaking. Punjabi has its own way of speaking. So each language has its pronunciation system. That you must know. So we are going to discuss about pronunciation only today. In our syllabus, that is pronunciation skill. Means how English is spoken. So today we will learn about this, how English is spoken, how the words can be spoken. Then in the next lecture, we will discuss about stress and intonation. Then let us move to what are the speaking skills in which most of the words, there are three parts, visual, vocal and verbal, only 7% verbal. That is some research said that 38% is related to tone, the voice, the modulation, and 55% related to our body language. It is also part of speaking skill. When I am speaking, I am using my body. But we will concentrate on pronunciation skill. What should you keep in mind when you speak? A brief overview and quick overview. First is you should select proper words. When will word come? You have lots of active words in your mind. Otherwise, you need to think about the words and there will not be any fluency in your speaking. Then it's correct pronunciation. This is the factors that you keep in mind while speaking, learning speaking. You should pronounce words correctly. Third is you should be grammatically correct. You should not make grammatical mistakes. Third is you should think about who is listening. When you are speaking, you should think about who is listening. Who is your audience? As a teacher, we should think, how are our students? What is the nature of their students? Facial expressions. Because when you are speaking, facial expressions also help you convey the message. It makes your speaking effective. We know that when we are crying, our facial expression changes. When we are laughing, when we are in a jovial mood, when we are very much happy, our speaking has also different facial expression on. Then voice modulation. What is voice modulation? Some of the people speak faster. Some of the people speak slower. Some have very high loudness in their voice. Some are not loud. They are very soft in their voice. So this is modulation. This is called modulation. Some have the way of speaking in a dramatic manner. Some of the people have a manner of speaking seriously. They are always serious when they speak. So that is voice modulation. Then body language, we know that how we are standing, how we are sitting, what is the posture of our body, how we are using our hands, eyes, head, everything, that is body language. How confident are we? Then gestures and postures, in what position, what posture we are sitting. This is what we should keep in mind while speaking.